What's going on, guys? Gamer Alpha 420 here, back with another banger. Now, the loyal fans may have noticed that I'm taking a short hiatus from Minecraft forever. So, I've been playing a lot of Terraria recently. For anyone who hasn't played Terraria, it's pretty much just like 2D Minecraft, but without the carpal tunnel. Anywho, I realized that on YouTube there was a stark lack of automated farms for Terraria's most useful item. So I thought I would do the community a favor and design a tombstone farm myself. Now, you may be wondering, what use could having an automatic tombstone farm possibly serve when I could just go die 6 times myself and get every advantage from the graveyard biome? Well, I don't know. But I found Beethoven befitting of the elegance of my farm. So enjoy a little bit of Sonata 14 in this short introduction. So I left my Lego character in this dungeon for just over an hour and got 121 total tombstones, which equals out to around 2 tombstones per minute. One nice thing about this design is that it can be built pre-hard mode and pre-mechanic, and it's relatively cheap. Another quirk is that this farm is designed specifically for legendary mode, which is the game mode you get when you select master mode on the Seed Get Fixed Boy. Now, you don't need to build the farm in legendary mode, but you will have to at least create a legendary world to take resources from if you want to build the farm in pre-hard mode. I made an alternate legendary world for this and was able to build the farm from scratch in about 2 hours. So stop breathing so loud so I can explain this. Yeah, you. So the farm makes use of a naturally generating boulder trap to get wiring pre-mechanic. Then it utilizes a makeshift electrical clock with skeletons and an entity pressure plate. The clock turns off and on one of the actuated blocks you get from the boulder trap to break the tombstones and also trigger the geyser. You set your spawn at the bed, and when you respawn you are pushed by conveyors into a flake mechanism, which I will explain later, which teleports you into the death chamber so that you can drop the tombstone onto the actuated block. If you're doing this with a mechanic, you obviously have a lot more leeway, and you can just skip finding a boulder trap and also just use a regular clock, unless you just want to rough it like your pre-mechanic ancestors did, in which case, good for you. I wish you the best reconnecting with all the green slimes of the wilderness. Additionally, if you use the farm with more than 10 gold in your inventory, you can make sure you're always getting the golden tombstone variants. And so long as the farm is filled in with safe placed background balls, there's no chance for coins to be picked up by worms or ghosts while AFK. I'll put a list of all the materials you need for the farm on screen. First, you're going to need 8 conveyors of the same direction, which can be purchased from the steampunker at the start of your legendary world. I used the counterclockwise conveyors in my farm. Normally, the steampunker is a hard mode NPC, however, in legendary worlds, the NPC is present only for the first 1 day cycle before dying spontaneously, so purchase the conveyors quickly to avoid creating a new world. In my new world, I started by breaking pots and trees to collect goods that I could sell to the merchants to afford the conveyors. Next, you're going to need around 500 wood of any type, give or take, for building the frame and other supplies. You're also going to need 2 pressure plates, at least one being activated by entities. Brown and gray player-activated pressure plates can be found hooked up to most underground traps, and red entity-triggered pressure plates can be found in some underground cabins. You're going to also need an enemy statue of some kind to trigger the red pressure plate. In my main playthrough, I found a skeleton statue that works really well, however most statues will at least work in some capacity. In my new world, I found an undead Viking statue, which worked fine, however I ended up not being able to use a door in the clock because they got stuck trying to knock it down, and they wouldn't step on the red pressure plate. Next, you're going to need a bed which can be crafted using cobwebs and a loom to make silk, and then silk with wood in a sawmill. Then you need to locate a geyser trap, which can be found randomly generated in the underworld and lower cavern layers. In my new playthrough, I was having some trouble finding a geyser, so instead I set my sights on finding a rare rainbow kidney structure, which can contain several geyser traps. Luckily, I was able to get a few geysers from one of those, however, when I tested the flame ability, something didn't sit quite right, so I ended up throwing those out because I think they must have gone stale inside of the kidney. I was able to find a ripe geyser a few minutes later, and I used that one instead. You're also going to want to craft a trapdoor and two regular doors for the clock and exit. Now, assuming that you found a boulder trap that reaches at least 20 blocks from its actuators to a pressure plate, you can begin building a farm. To start, you want to break all of the actuated blocks, then place a 2x1 platform with one actuated block and one wood block or block of your choice 2 blocks under where the previous bottom actuators were. I forgot to move the platform down in my new world, so it kind of messed up the shape of the death chamber, but everything still worked. After you've done that, make sure you've placed the actuated block on a space with wire by going 4 blocks down and building another platform and then testing it with the player trigger pressure plate under the actuator. If the actuated block isn't triggered, try moving it and the pressure plate left or right until you hit the wire line. Once your platform is in the right location, you can go up 3 blocks from the top platform and place 2 actual platforms of any type. Then place walls connecting the 2 top platforms, one thick on the right and 2 thick on the left, assuming that you're using counterclockwise conveyors. Then place a 9-block platform, 1 space under the top platform and 1 space right of the right wall. Place the 8 conveyors on top of the platform except for the last block, instead place wood. Then place 8 additional blocks above the last wood block on the right. Build up the left wall 4 more blocks and then extend a roof just high enough for you to fit across into the 10 block wall. Then just do exactly what I do here for the Hoik. All we really need to know about Hoiks is that they let you glitch through walls quickly so long as the blocks and platforms are hammered in the correct direction. There's definitely other videos on how Hoiks work if you want to use it for other things, but you don't really need to know anything else for this design. Next, break these 3 blocks of the roof and then place 2 platforms in the very right space. Next, extend a roof from the top of the far right wall to the block to the left of the hole in the roof, then extend 1 block down. Then you should be able to place a door to exit and fill the interior with safe background walls. Place the bed on the remaining 4 blocks of the conveyor and make sure to light up the inside with torches. Finally, place the geyser on top of the platform in the death chamber, and so long as you've situated the first platform correctly, it should be hooked up to the wire line. Now that's the farm done. For the clock, go down to the platform with the player pressure plate and make sure that there is 1 block to the left of the wire line and 8 blocks to the right. Next, build down 12 blocks on the side and connect to make a 13x10 box. Mine the 2 blocks left of the right wall on the roof and extend another wall down to the bottom. Next, build this upside down L 4 blocks under the platform, reaching 3 blocks from the bottom. Place a door at the bottom and a trap door to the right of the L. You don't need to place background walls inside the clock, but I did in my main playthrough because it looked objectively better. Next, place your statue and entity-activated pressure plate in their respective positions on the wire line, and place a platform so that you can enter and exit the access chute. Now you can connect the 2 rooms however you'd like, and that should be the build done. Just step on the player pressure plate 3 times to activate the statue, and then trap the skeletons with the entity pressure plate to start the clock. Then set your spawn at the bed and die to start farming. Now, I literally can't think of a single good reason to build this farm, so you've made it this far in the video. I think we can mutually agree not to share our personal endeavors with this farm and go our separate ways. Yep, bye. Then just do exactly what I do here for the hoik. All you're in rear on the roof and then extend one block down. Next, oh my god, this is terrible. And one wood block or block of your choice, two blocks under the previous platform. No, I messed it up, dude. Stop looking at me. Stop. Go down to the platform with the player pressure plate and make sure